Let's talk about Greenland. Greenland isn't actually green, it's actually what becomes snow and ice.
Greenland is located between North America and Europe, and it is in the northern hemisphere of the world.
Hey!
Get out of our video! Unless you have something to say.
I don't.
Do you know anything about Greenland?
No.
As you can see, many people don't know about Greenland. Why don't we start with some basic facts then?
Greenland is a part of Denmark.
Greenland has less than 57,000 inhabitants. The reason probably being the climate and the difficulties people have to face.
People living in Greenland, also known as Inuit, have to face the harsh conditions of Greenland. Greenland has an Arctic climate with average temperatures that do not exceed 10 degrees Celsius in the warmest summer months.
Wow, that's cool. I like it.
Greenland sounds like an awful place, but it's actually really interesting. Did you know the first people who stepped foot on Greenland were Vikings?
Vikings are those people who carry wooden shields and swords with longboats and those horn hat things, right?
Yeah, something like that. Vikings are North Sea farers, mainly speaking Old Norse language, who traded from their northern European homelands across wide areas of northern, central and eastern Europe. During the late 8th to late 11th centuries, the early Viking settlers named the island Greenland.
Well then, why don't you do some ice fishing then?
What's that?
It's an activity that the Inuits do to occupy themselves when they feel bored. You can stay over after the performances to do some ice fishing at the high school booth.
We've briefly covered geography and the basic history of Greenland. Now let's talk more about tourism, agriculture and culture. Like any other country, Greenland has many tourist attraction to visit. Large historical buildings such as the Nuuk Art Museum, Kvitfjord Museum, the Nuuk Cathedral, and the Havasi.
But there are also natural attractions, the Rasu Glacier, the Northeast Greenland National Park, Samisiak, the Mount Forel are few of breathtaking attractions for tourists.
you should have seen Devin's face when you say those names. Now I'm starving. I could really eat a whale right now.
Greenland cuisine actually included whale meat.
I was just kidding.
The national dish of Greenland is suwarsan, a traditional Greenlandic soup. It is often made from seal or from whale, or reindeer or seabird. The soup often includes onions and potatoes, and is simply seasoned with salt and pepper, or bay leaf. The soup is often thickened with rice or by soaking barley into water overnight so that the starch enters the water.
Sounds delicious! Greenlandic cuisine is traditionally based on meat from marine mammals, game, birds, and fish, which contain high levels of protein. Since colonization and the arrival of international trade, the cuisine has been increasingly influenced by Canadian and Danish cuisine.
And finally, agriculture. There are just a few dozen sheep farms in southern Greenland, where most of the impact of climate change can be seen. But with 57,000 mostly Inuit human inhabitants, the number to feed are also small.
Crops include beans, peas, herbs, strawberries, potatoes, tomatoes, peppers, and much, much more. However, the country's economy mostly relies on exports of shrimp and fish. And on a significant funding from Danish government, fish account for every 90% of its exports, subjecting the economy to differences in world demand.
And what about the people? Are they nice? Where are they from? What about their lifestyle?
The culture of Greenland has much in common with Greenland, the Inuit tradition. As the majority of people are descended from Inuit, many people still go ice fishing, and there are no dog sledges in which everyone with the team participating has. However, Greenland has now become somewhat of tourist attraction.
The official language is West Greenlandic, which all children learn, including Danish and English.
Greenland has a population of roughly 57,000, 15,000 of whom living in the capital Nuuk. The inhabitants of Greenland are originated from the Central Asia.
Phew! After all those facts about Greenland, I think my brain needs a break.
Hey, last thing guys, if I want to go to Greenland from Thailand, how many hours does it take?
The distance between Greenland and Thailand is about 9,930 kilometers, which is 6,160 miles.
If you travel with an airplane from Greenland to Thailand, it takes around 11 hours to arrive at your destination.
Wow!
Okay everyone, before we end this video, nope, not really. Okay, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. See ya.